Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see about how to represent a number, negative number, -77.25 as an 1-bit 8-bit complement, okay, 1-bit complement number of 8 bits. So we all know that the numbers, negative numbers are represented using the complement. That may be 1's complement or 2's complement or 9's complement or 10's complement. So complement number is mainly used for mentioning the negative number as well as to perform the subtraction. So now, in order to find out, first of all, to find out the binary values, thus I am giving a shortcut method. What is the shortcut here is just to write the powers of 2 from left to right to the left. Like it is actually 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3, etc. So as a multiple of 2, so this will be 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. Instead of dividing the number by 2 and finding all the remainders by the usual method, this is a shortcut method to find out the binary equivalent of a given number. So now you have to first find out 77 as the combination of these numbers available. So we can assure that this number will not go beyond 64, because 64 plus something we can get around at, we can get arrive at 77. So 64 plus 13 is actually 77. Okay, so 4 plus 3 is 7, 6 plus 1 is 7. So we have to just make as a addition of 64 plus remaining of these terms 13. So how this 13 will come? This 13 will come from 8 plus 4, 12, 12 plus 1, 13. So like this we can make some summation as a guess, so that we can avoid the long division by the 2 and then collecting the 1s and the zeros as the usual method. If you are not familiar with this method, you can learn this method, is very easy. Otherwise also you can use the double double method as you wish. But this is a shortcut method, it is a time consuming process, because we know that in the NET examination everything should be done in a very faster manner. Okay. So now coming to the point here, now this whole number part is over. For this 77, I have told how to find out this value as 67 plus 13, which is 77. So we have to arrive at some 64, because beyond this number will not go, because here itself we have 64. Then we have found out that 64 from 13. For 13 we get the addition as 8 plus 4, 12, 12 plus 1 is 13. So wherever these numbers are needed, so we need 64 plus 8 plus 4 plus 1. So put 1 in all those digits whichever we are using to arrive the 77. So 64 you have put 1, for 8 you put 1, for 4 you put 1, for 1 you put 1, because we need all these numbers added up to give this number 77. Remaining are 0. So this is the shortcut to find out the binary equivalent of the given number. Okay. So now coming to the fractional part, how to convert the fractional part? We know that fractional part has to be multiplied by the power of 2, so into 2 actually. So into 2. So into 2 is actually 0.50. So then take this fractional part, multiply again by 2, we are arriving at 1.00. Even if you multiply again 0, it will be again 0 only. So this multiplication can be stopped when the number becomes 0. So now we have to, now this is the way we have found out the, and the numbers are calculated from top to bottom. Okay, so top to, so value is 0, 1, 0, and as many numbers add we can add to the end. Okay, so the number starts from 0, 1, 0. So now the number, for the -77.25, first we have found out everything from 77, we have found out the binary value. For 20.25, we have found out the binary value. Now we have to write these numbers combined to mention 77.25, and then it is -77.25. So naturally we can see that how to write this number here. So write the number as this number. So 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1. Okay. So you have to write this number 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1. 0.0100, which you have got from the fractional part. So we have combinedly, we have write the fractional part as well as the whole number part. So how to find the ones complement? We have to convert all the zeros to ones. So every zeros changes to one, that is the ones complement. So we have to write as 1011 0010.1011. So this is the ones complement of the given number. So this is the way we have to find out the ones complement of the given number. Hope it will be easy for everyone to follow this. So here the main thing, the time saving process is all about how to convert the long decimal number into a binary number using this shortcut method. Hope you all understood how to make this calculation faster, and it will help you to save the time in the examination. And thanks for watching.